I'm just waiting for the stream to let me know it started. Hello, I'm Hal Thompson, an autumnal expert. This is my AutumnHal special. And I'm gonna talk to you tonight about a number of very important topics.
I better stop this from making noise and coming at me.
I'll be looking at your comments in the comment section and maybe giving away some items, that special items that I have. But now here's my official intro to this program. Every autumn, we watch as the leaves fall gently from the trees. They grow orange, they grow yellow and brown, and then they fall down. They hit the ground. It's this time of year that we like to reflect upon our activities and look at ourselves in a new light. Perhaps the light that we have in the kitchen if we're making dinner, or the light of the dawn of a new beginning as we face our fears and find. I feel like this is turning into some sort of sermon. I'm Hal Thompson, and I'm an expert. You can ask me questions. I'll answer your questions to the best of my expert abilities. I went to expert school. I have a degree in expertology. I'm gonna get right to some of your comments as we get started on this Equinox special. I'm your AutumnHal friend. Here is a giant squash, a pumpkin, some butter beer. I can predict your doom tonight with this little crystalline object. Oh, and then I also have some orange leaves to make it feel festive. Feeling festive is important. Noticing that the seasons pass, feeling it in your ass. Will there be a Kritch visit tonight? I assume so. I haven't heard from Kritch for a while, ever since my liaison with Lady Tink in the Victorian era. But I think she's maybe getting over it now that it's fall, her favorite season. I expect her to give me a ring. Or else. Hal, do eggs like to float in outer space? I'm not clear that they like to float in outer space, but they don't have a choice. Sometimes when when eggs enter a gravitational field of a black hole, they go inside and they come out the other end made into a fried egg over medium. No one knows why. It's an ancient and eternal question. Once I talked to Galactus about this question, he didn't know why that would happen to eggs. And then he devoured the planet that I was on, so I had to get going. I had some help from Courtney, who's on the comment feed this evening. She helped me decorate with this nice tree. And she's always a very helpful person. She brings a lot to my life. Is God dead? If so, who killed him? I don't know whether God is alive or not. I'd have to check in with Jesus, but I haven't spoken to Jesus for a few years.
Maybe we could call him tonight.
We might try to call Jesus tonight, see how God's doing. That's something we can do here now that it's the equinox and the planets are aligned and at the right tilt. If the Earth's tilt is at the right angle, since we're only one day out from the equinox, we can probably reach Jesus on the phone. Not sure. What gives pine trees the ultimate power to survive the winter? Pine trees have a special cryo substance in all of their needles. In fact, if you trim pine trees' needles off of the branches and stick enough of them into your skin, you can preserve yourself cryogenically for hundreds of years. The only problem is that you bleed out when someone pulls all the needles out. So they would have to find a solution for bleeding out from tens of thousands of small holes pricked in your body and skin. If you wanted to just preserve one body part, for example, your nose, you could just stick that full of pine needles, and then your nose would get preserved. I recommend it. I just want to let you know, I might give away some things tonight. A festive orange shirt, just in time for the fall. Perhaps you'll like what this shirt says on it, if you're that kind of person. I got this shirt at the bargain shops. Fart, now loading. And then it's at 85%. So you only have to wait for a little bit longer for it to finish loading. Just only 15% left before the fart's fully loaded. You can entertain your family at Thanksgiving with this amazing shirt. It's pretty funny if you think about it, because like loading farts. Anyway, if you want to win this shirt, it's an extra large t-shirt. And for every donation of $20 or multiples thereof, you'll get entered. So for example, if it was 40, that would be 2, and so on and so forth. There's a lot of options down in the description of the video. By now, the fart would be 100% loaded. You'll have to buy yourself another shirt for when the fart's fully loaded, so you can finish the joke. I have another shirt. If you win tonight, I'll have 2 winners, and if you win tonight, you'll have your choice of these 2 shirts. This one's green, which is nice, and then it says this, Baywatch. I think this is like sort of a riff on the weather patterns. Like when there's a tornado, it's a tornado watch. This is when you're looking out for your a bay. I'm not sure what a bay is. Bay, if it was a bay with water, that would be B-A-Y. I think bay might be a demon. And then, of course, second prize tonight gets a signed Hal Thompson postcard. Signed by me and also that other jerk. I don't like him. Don't go to his website, aaronyanda.com. I heard that it's a nasty pile of filth. So don't go to aaronyanda.com. Some people were saying it looks really good, but I couldn't agree with them because I don't like it. I don't like him. And then also, I wanted to say if you want to get in touch with me, you can leave a comment and I'll be looking at those right now. How can you seduce a lady to perform the mandatory summoning ritual of the season? The mandatory summoning ritual can be achieved in a number of different ways. It helps if you have the lady there to help you achieve the summoning. The best way to achieve the summoning with a lady is to convince her to sit upon the special podium that you've prepared for her, the vibrating podium. She should sit on that for a good 15 minutes, and once it has finished vibrating, begin the summoning ritual. That's what they used to do in Rome, anyway. Are you nervous that the goats are going into hibernation soon? Not all goats go into hibernation, just the lazy ones. So I usually just prepare a spot in the basement for those goats. Sometimes I use pine needles. I stick pine needles in the goat's skin to preserve them for years and years. I have a goat in hibernation right now, cryo-hibernation. I'm going to wake him up next month, and he'll probably just bleed out and die. But at least I could have a quick conversation with him before he does and tell him about all the things that have happened since 2008. when I put him into cryo hibernation and just get his reaction. Maybe I'll videotape it. I'll try to tape up the tens of thousands of holes in his body, but it doesn't usually work. How do you look so good and be an expert? Luckily, I'm also a looks expert. I know what makes things happen for my looks and face. My coat is always in season, and even in autumn, and even in summer. It's a all-season coat, just like tires are all season. This coat is also all season. Luckily for me, I've had this shirt since 1986, and it's never gone out of fashion. Sometimes you get lucky with the shirt, and it looks eternal, and you never have to worry. I wore this shirt and jacket to Victorian times to visit Lady Tink, and nobody noticed. They all thought I looked pretty much like they did.
Just like the doctor.
Just like the doctor. Carbonite makes fewer holes, but carbonite's pretty expensive. It's easier to pluck needles off of pine trees and stick those in the skin of goats. If you want a shout-out, I can give you a shout-out or answer a specific question. There's a level in the description of this video that allows for that. By the way, my friend Dylan will be joining me in a little while. I'm also going to hopefully talk to some other people, including Dr. Moley and possibly, hopefully not Munt, and then maybe Jesus as well. How do you summon an autumnal demon? You need 300 dried orange leaves, and you need a match, and you need a salad, a blueberry salad, and you put all the leaves in the blueberry salad and toss the salad and then light the match, and that usually summons a pretty good autumnal demon. There's a variety of ways. That's just one I've been messing with. There's somebody out in my parking lot. I hope they don't see me doing this.
Why?
I don't want to be discovered. I try to keep a private life. I join you every now and then to give you my expertise, but I'm a very solitary person, except for the myriad of goats who celebrate my life with me.
Can you sing an 80s autumnal song? Is a question.
Can I sing an 80s autumnal song? Yeah. I would need a song title. As a suggestion. It's Up to You is the name of the song. Maybe someone could suggest a song title for an autumnal 80s song. Can you teleport to Venus and come back faster than the speed of light? Well, if you're teleporting, you're already traveling faster than the speed of light. I think you've answered your own question.
Hal, do you love autumn, or is this part of your autumnal trickery?
Sometimes I do get a little bit tricky. I have some satyr's blood in my body, and maybe the blood of Pan. And sometimes I get a little saucy and sassy and nippy. But most of the time, I'm pretty straightforward and honest as an expert. For example, I told you a little bit about how I like to be a solitary person, just surrounded by goats. I also don't like to be touched. Sometimes I'll go out in crowds and people will accidentally brush against me, and it gives me the shivers, and I fall over, and I start having a spasm. So if you ever see me in public, please don't touch me. I got something here from Mike Bauer. Hey, expert, have a shot. Sometimes I like to indulge in a potion during our live shows. This evening, I have a special glass for my potions. My potion bottles were all recently damaged in a freak potion disaster. I got some special potion liquid from my granddad, who was also old. I'll take a shot of this in honor of Mike. Thank you, Mike. Here's to autumn This potion is the color of a delicious autumn leaf. Now we're getting somewhere. You can shout questions to me if I miss them on the feed. It's hard for me to see because I have glasses. Did I say everything about the items I'm giving away and the other things I needed to say? Dearest Courtney?
Did you? I don't know. I missed that. I'm talking to the folks.
Did you come up? Did you have an 80s song that I should sing about the Equinox?
We have a bunch of them. We have Weird Science, Heat of the Moment, Pac-Man Fever, Falling into Goats, Dead Man's Party.
These are all actual 80s songs.
Some have a few substitute words. Don't you know any of those?
How about...
You know, Heat of the Moment.
In the heat of the autumn, I found myself in a wonderful park. In the heat of the autumn, I found myself without looking too far. I was at a park in the heat of the autumn. There were leaves and they fall on me in the heat of the autumn. Everybody saw me and they thought I was a freak. That's been my experience in parks, unfortunately, which is why I like to stay solitary and keep to my goats. You can quote that if you want about me. I like to stay solitary and keep to my goats. Hal, I have a question. Come to Brazil. That's not a question unless you have a question mark. Then it would be come to Brazil. But that wouldn't make sense. Okay, I'll be to Brazil later tomorrow. I'm making an appearance. I'm signing for my new book, Hal Thompson, Expert in His House. That's the title of my new book. It's all about the things I've discovered while in my house, being solitary and keeping to my goats. It's not safe outside and out of doors anymore. There's a lot of storms. Recently I was nearly struck by lightning and it rained. I had to run. At least I thought I was going to be struck by lightning because I saw some. I ran all the way, but I went to the wrong house, and once I was inside the house there was three men. And they all had dark coats and dark hair and weird looking. I can't really describe them anymore without sounding racist. In fact, what I meant was they were not men at all. They were, never mind. Let's move forward. I shouldn't have gone in that house. There was nobody in there except for some nice old ladies. I shouldn't have said they were men. The Reflex by Duran Duran. I think I heard that song back when I was getting beaten in high school. The Reflex. It's the autumn way to find yourself a nice park. Everybody goes to the park with the reflexes intact. Pretty much how it goes. Is there a fall goat ritual you perform in order to keep the harvest safe? I perform so many goat rituals, it's hard to keep track of which ones actually keep the harvest safe. But I do try to help farmers when they contact me. Sometimes I get texts from farmers. They say, "Hal, can you protect my harvest?" And then they put an emoticon in that has a picture of wheat. Oh, it looks like this might be Kritch. I better take this. Hello?
Hello?
This is Hal. Hal Thompson.
What are you doing?
I'm doing my AutumnHal Equinox special.
Are you in our time or Edwardian times?
I'm in the current time. I haven't been back to Edwardian times for a while.
You haven't seen Lady Tink?
No, I haven't seen Lady Tink for a while. I've been pretty busy keeping to myself and tending to the goats.
You think you're lying, Hal?
No, I wouldn't. I couldn't lie to you.
Did you know that the most murders in any given year are committed on the autumnal equinox?
I didn't know that fact. Where can you cite your source?
Well, you better look it up online, Hal, and you better watch out. Huh.
Okay, thanks for the information, Kritch. Oh, she hung up. Apparently, most murders are committed on the autumnal equinox. I guess that's why I have been talking about keeping to myself and staying alone. You don't get murdered by goats, as long as you don't upset them too much. I'm not sure why you would say my phone case is lame. My phone case is cool, just like bow ties, and time travel, and feeling special. I might be getting another call. I'm going to be calling someone in a minute, but not right this second. Apparently, Dr. Moley is busy dealing with some rogue children in his house, and he can't take a phone call right now, so we'll call him in a little bit. Thank you for joining me this evening. It's always a pleasure to chat with you and answer your questions. I think my knee hurts because of the damn moon and planets and shit. How to cure this, Hal? Says Rick. The best way to cure a hurt knee is to go into your laboratory and sit yourself down on the table, the operation table. This is a pretty easy self-operation. All you need is a $3-$5 bills duct tape together, wrap those $5 bills around your knee, and then every time you look down at your knee, you'll see the money. Sound good? Should I crappy on my cat, says Shorty's Gaming. I'm not sure how you crappy on a cat. But I'm pretty sure that cat wouldn't like it. I think instead you shouldn't crappy on your cat, and you should choose a different course of action. Cats are known to be vengeful animals. They could extract revenge in the form of infecting you with bacteria that can't be affected by antibiotics. Cats are known carriers of extra strong bacteria in their feces. They often infect you with madness. Cat poo-poo is known to be a cause of madness and insanity. Very slow, just over the course of years. Cats are evil. I got something from Seth H. He says, predict my doom. I will predict Seth H's doom. It is often very violent and unfortunate, but it is the truth and it is how you will go. If you want me to do this, check the description for information on how to make it happen. I have to go into a special trance in order to predict Seth H's doom. Seth H, you will perish in a storm, storm of intense hail, rain, and metal. Sheets of metal will fall from the sky along with the rain and hail. In this storm, many people will perish. You won't perish from the things falling from the sky, however. You will perish from a bad diet that just happens to kill you during that incredible storm. I don't know what I just said, but I hope that you understand now what will cause your death, Seth. Seth's death. That's kind of hard to say. I think that's almost a tongue twister. How many times can you say that before you stop? try it right now at home. I bet you just stopped. I got a shout out from Eric Ross. He wants this shout out to Cherry Pie, the Thai hooker. Cherry Pie had to move out of our city. She was in a lot of trouble for all the things that she'd done and the fracas that she'd created. I think that's how you pronounce it, fracas. Anyway, she got in a lot of fights and she got in a lot of trouble and she moved up north. And she doesn't live here anymore, but I imagine right now she's shooting ping pong balls around the room with her privates and yelling at some man on the street corner, just like she does. Here's to you, Cherry Pie, from Eric. I hope things are going well for you up in the woods. I hope she's careful. There's dangerous owls up in the North Woods. I've heard they carry Thai hookers away in the middle of the night. Dr. Moley's still taking care of those rogue children.
Hal, is it true you'll murder Matt Sloaney during the autumnal equinox and take over Welcome to the Basement?
Matt Sloaney, I'm not sure. I think I may have heard of that show. At least I know I've been over to a basement once. But I don't generally murder anybody unless they cross me. If anyone steps to me in a way that I consider too much, I will lash out. That's what all the guns is for. Just kidding, I don't have any weapons. I'm mostly non-violent. But like I said, if someone does step to me, I can take out the trash. I'm rash. I'm very brash. And I've got cash. I'm friends with Slash from Guns N' Roses. And he's friends with Moses. I was just freestyling. A man without ham cannot be trusted, but are there other meats that also provide information? All meat provides some sort of information. It just depends on how much meat you'd like to carry. The most important one is ham if you want to be trusted. Anyone you meet who is new to you and you do not know, present your ham immediately. Whip that right out and let them know that you are trustworthy. Other types of ham meat, such as beef, or bacon can also be used to make a statement, but usually this statement is just, I have meat. Ham makes a different statement altogether. And also, if you present someone with calf livers, that means that you are a drug dealer. Calf livers are known to be a way to deliver drugs. I don't know why I don't make the rules. Courtney, are you into cider beer?
Oh, where is that? Oh, Catherine.
Can you speak towards the mic and shout?
I like cider beer. I don't drink a ton of beer, but I do like cider beers.
She likes cider beer, to answer your question.
Like pretty much anything autumnal.
She likes all things autumnal. She's a bit of an autumnal... she's obsessed.
Aficionado?
What?
Aficionado?
She's an autumnal aficionado. Don't mess with her during autumn. She loves it. If a man carries bologna instead of ham, is he not trustworthy? To a lesser extent, you can be trustworthy with bologna, but like I said, it's no substitute for ham. So why pester me with these questions? Just go get ham. Bologna is good for sandwiches, and ham is good for trust. This expert got impatient with you. I accept all questions with equal import, and no question is a bad question. You will all be presented with trophies at the end of this live broadcast. I want all of you to feel good about yourselves, and to know that you are valuable as a human. Just exactly how many people value you is up for grabs, though. Or debate.
Could you list the prizes again, Hal? Someone had emailed.
The prizes. This is one of the prizes right here. If you get first place tonight when we do the random drawing at the end, you can be sent this t-shirt that says Bay Watch. Do you get it? Because I don't. The other option, if you don't want that fabulous Bay Watch shirt, is this. This lets everyone know how much of your fart has been loaded. This is important information, people. They're both extra large and very brightly colored.
Can I say something about that?
Yes.
My mom and I were in Wisconsin Dells like a year ago, eating in a restaurant, and from the window we could see that t-shirt in the store, and it was closed. I was going to get it for you to give away.
Luckily,
now you finally did it.
Luckily, you didn't have to because I broke into that store and took it. That store's been closed for a while, but I needed this shirt for this show. I knew that some of you needed to provide information about how much of your farts have loaded. And then if you win second prize, you can have this. It's a postcard of me. What else could you want? It's signed by me and that in AaronYanda.com, and maybe Dylan will sign it when he shows up.
Where did you get those fabulous postcards?
Those postcards were provided to me by Sean Henry. He's a good friend. He's a good Canadian friend. You should always have at least one Canadian friend. If you don't have a Canadian friend, you don't understand what you're missing. Canadian friends are some of the best in the world. Cheers to Sean Henry. When sevens are dark water, mambo dog face to the banana patch. The answer that you want there is Steve Martin. Hal, are parsnips just the ghosts of carrots? That's true, actually. Parsnips are the ghosts of carrots. When a carrot dies, its soul travels until it finds a piece of ground to inhabit, and then it grows into a parsnip. Parsnips contain the souls of dead carrots. This is known to many good cooks. Many a cook will make a dish with carrots, and if you cook the carrot just right, you can keep the soul in the dead carrot. And then the food is seasoned with dead carrot soul and tastes better that way. Many fine restaurants know how to keep the carrot soul alive or contained, and thus a delicious meal. If you figure out how to do this on your own, you might be able to enhance your home menu. How do I make up for hurting a circle's feelings on this autumnal equinox, Knox, says Chris Olson. You hurt a circle's feelings? What you should do is equally offend all different shapes then. And this might take you a little while, but it's important. So the circle doesn't feel like you singled it out. Go offend a square, a rhomboid, a trapezoid, an isosceles triangle, an uneven, lopsided, muddled sort of shape. And don't forget to insult rectangles. Rectangles are actually deserving of insults. Rectangles are the worst shape. Also the most common shape, but they're just not good shapes. The gourd in the foreground is very dong-like. You mean like a bell? I suppose it could be considered sort of a dong. If you turn it upside down, it looks more like a water tower. A big green water tower gourd. I was under the impression this was some sort of squash. Anything that's not a pumpkin, I think, is just a squash. Or also some sort of gourd. How do I dismantle the masquerade? When your masquerade comes to an end and you need for it to be over, simply tell the musicians to quietly fade their last song ever so gradually down until there's only one tiny note plucked on a mandolin, and continue that plucking. This will signal all of the guests at the masquerade to head out. And it's also the most exciting, not exciting, but classy and classic way to let your guests know that the masquerade is over. I learned this from Lady Tink. I went to a number of masquerades. One of the masquerades we went to, most of the people were not wearing much for clothing, which is weird for that era. But luckily I got right out of there. Many people tried to touch me, and that's not okay. All touches are a bad touch for Hal Thompson. You don't have to ask me where on my body someone touched me in a bad way. It's all bad touch. Why does the small pumpkin get to sit on the tiny couch while the squash is put on the table? Is it being punished? I thought maybe it was a little big to sit on that couch, but I didn't really think about it. You're making a good point, and it's something I need to consider. Maybe this squash can sit up here if I do things right. Because you're lucky to sit on the miniature couch, squash. Squash, stop tipping over. This is what I was afraid of, but look, I've done it. The squash is on the miniature couch. I bet it feels lucky. How do I change the radio station in my head? What you need is a special thought dial. You can buy one of these at Marshall's. Marshall's is the only place that I know of that sells thought dials for your radio head. You could also buy the new album by Radiohead and just play that, and that should turn it off. Hal is gonna knock that beer over. My butter beer is safe. I will contain it within my body where it cannot be knocked. I've got a message from Brad Wagner. He says, a potion for Hal plus Miss Courtney. Aww. Let me get that potion ready. It's a potion from old granddad. When Dylan gets here, if you want to give him something surprising made from sage, just let me know. And we'll be sure to get him. Would you like a shot of this?
Yeah.
Can you grab yourself a glass? I don't seem to have one handy.
You Horbe.
Court Horbe. Court Norbe. Court Norbert. Thanks to my granddad for supplying me with whiskey. I mean potion. I just gave myself away. What?
Beeford.
Thank you to Beeford. Beeford Wagner. I think your new nickname should be Beeford. Makes you sound a little bit more tough and manly. Consider calling yourself Beeford. Here we go with the delicious sage beverage for the wonderful Courtney. Here's your beverage.
Thank you, Brad.
Thank you, Brad. Hal, let me take my potion first and then I'll answer your question. There's just one of these left for Dylan. Thank you, Beefer. Delicious potion. I feel enhanced. Hal, can you ask for a better autumnal equinox? Maybe if it was a little bit less humid. But if you're asking how I could ask for it, the best way would be to do it politely and say, dear weather patterns, could you treat me right this autumnal equinox with a light breeze and maybe something in the 70s? Because weather patterns like it when you rhyme. That's the best way to do it, though. You've learned it from the best. Don't mess with the best.
Mr. Stevens posted. I think you should read his comment.
Mr. Stevens. I didn't see it. I think I missed it.
Says my children are in need of my assistance. I'm either going to need to go to them or be whatever I'm being with Hal.
Oh.
So maybe you should.
I understand. I should probably be calling somebody. Let's do that right away. Let's see who I get. You never know who I'm gonna call. That's part of the fun. Who will answer this?
Hello?
Hello, is this Dr. Moley?
Yes.
Hello, Dr. Moley, this is Hal Thompson.
Yes.
Did you deal with the rogue children that were running through your house?
Yes, they came in through the front door and they picked up a pumpkin patch.
It's good that they didn't come in through the bathroom window.
No, I nailed it shut so that the ruffians couldn't get in anymore.
Oh, that's good. You've dealt with the ruffian issues you were having?
Yes. Those children, they ran through my house. They had gone to a pumpkin patch and they picked up all sorts of pumpkins and they smashed them on my Davenport.
Oh, what? So your Davenport is covered with pumpkin juice?
Yes, all of the seeds in the pumpkin guts.
Oh, that's terrible. That's really hard to get out of your Davenport.
I chased them away with a match.
What, with a match?
I lit a match.
And that's
good. And I said, I've got fire. You'd better run.
Oh, that was clever, Dr. Moley.
Oh, boy, did they run.
I'll have to remember that one when I'm facing off with all the ruffians that I face every day in the park.
Which park?
I went to my neighborhood park to enjoy the fall foliage, and I...
Oh, I like that park.
I bounced in the leaves, and then I was harassed.
Did the squirrels bother you, Hal?
No, the squirrels were fine. It was more the police.
You know, the police and I don't get along either.
I have a no-touch rule.
No-touch you or no-touch them?
No-touch me, and then the police don't care.
No. I've been tasered so many times my teeth glow.
I'm sorry to hear that, Dr. Moley. Why were you tasered?
I don't know. They still won't tell me.
Who's they?
The police.
They just tasered you?
They come by every Tuesday and Thursday. They really light me up.
Well, at least it's on a regular schedule.
Yes, I always know. I always know when it's time.
Do you wear anything special for your tasering? Your bi-weekly tasering?
I tried to wear rubber galoshes because I heard that could dull the zaps, but it didn't work.
It didn't work?
Nope.
I know, when I've been struck by lightning with rubber galoshes on, it didn't seem to help much either.
No, they'll melt right to your feet.
Yeah, I have a number of rubber galoshes melted to my feet right now.
How many? 12?
Oh, more than 12. I go through 13. A pair of galoshes every 2 weeks. My feet are giant rubber, they look like giant rubber mallets.
Oh, my. I'm sorry about your arm, Hal.
I'm just trying to hold up my phone. I recently installed a red dwarf in the power supply so I wouldn't have to charge it anymore.
Oh, that's very dense. The density of a red dwarf. No wonder your arm is aching.
That's exactly right.
I'll get you some pills that will numb your pains.
That would be great, Dr. Moley. I haven't gotten pills from you recently, and I've regretted it every day.
Every time I get a new batch, the police come and they zap me and they grab them.
The police are taking your pills? That's why they've dried up?
Yep.
That's unfortunate. Perhaps we'll have to prepare a surprise for those police.
No, 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 no.
No surprises?
No, I was on Facebook and the people said you have to obey the police. And you won't get hurt. But every time they come in and they hurt me bad.
Well, who was telling you this on Facebook, Dr. Moley? I don't know if you should take advice from that website.
Usually it's old white ladies.
I was in the old white lady's house recently.
Oh?
I accidentally went in there after I got touched.
Oh, did you find a doily?
I did. There was doilies everywhere.
She makes them she knits them or something out of crochet hooks or something.
Yeah, she does. She puts them together with the hooks.
I had a date with her one time. I don't know if you've got time for me to tell the story, but...
I do. I just got to adjust my arm due to the denseness of the red dwarf. Go ahead. Is it Mrs. Manderson?
Yes, Mrs. Manderson. I went over to her house and I said, I've been enjoying your commentary on Facebook about the police and how to not be abused by them. Would you like to go to the old country buffet with me and have some tilapia? And she said, yes. And so that's what we did. And I ate 4 bowls of apple pie filling. And then I took 4 big green stripy pills. And then I woke up in Anchorage, Alaska.
Was that your intent?
Yes.
Oh, you had taken the pills because you always end up in Anchorage, Alaska?
Every time.
That's very good. I could use some of those pills the next time I need to go to Anchorage for supplies.
I'll give you 2 and you'll end up in Saskatchewan.
Oh, that would be even better.
Yeah, there's free health care there. You can get those boots removed from your feet.
Oh, that would be nice, because it's hard to walk with all the rubber.
Yes. Jan Manderson.
Jan Manderson.
Old Jan.
I'm never going to her house again. She'll take the strap to me.
Some folks enjoy that. I don't.
I only enjoy it once every so often. So I know where to go, but I don't seek it out. I don't seek out the strap.
Hello?
Dr. Moley?
Hello. Who is this?
This is Hal Thompson.
Oh, hi, Hal. What's going on?
Are you in Alaska?
No. I'm at home.
Oh, good.
What do you want?
I just called you and had a long conversation.
No.
Okay, great.
Dr.
Moley?
Who's this?
This is Hal Thompson, the expert.
Oh, Hal. Hello, Hal.
Hello?
What do you want?
Hello, who's this?
What?
Hello?
Hi, who's this?
Who's this?
This is Dr. Moley.
Who's Dr. Moley?
It's me.
Thank you.
All right, you're welcome. Bye.
Bye. I forgot who I called for a second. I don't remember calling Dr. Moley. Does anyone else? Did one of you call Dr. Moley? That's confusing. Moley is caught in a phone loop. I believe that's true. Sometimes he gets caught in a phone loop and he recycles the phone call. In any case, I think we've learned to stay away from Mrs. Manderson's Man Panderson. What was her name?
Jan Manderson.
Jan Manderson. That's delicious butter beer. My friend Dylan is here. Dylan, would you like something to drink?
I brought some hams.
Dylan is extra trustworthy because his ham has 2 M's. Can we take a look?
Sure can, Hal. You gonna make a little room for Dull Dylan here?
Scoot on in, Dull Dylan.
Yep, that's me, Dull Dylan.
This is Dull Dylan. He's here to celebrate the autumnal equinox.
Happy Hal. You got the AutumnHal equinox.
AutumnHal.
AutumnHal
equinox. This is how you know Dylan is trustworthy due to the double M on his ham.
Double M. So how are everything has been going well for you? Nice to hear from Dr. Moley.
It was nice to hear from Dr. Moley. I had a bit of a slow start. I've been traveling a lot recently.
Oh, I thought you were talking about just your whole life.
I've been spending a lot of, for the most part, I've been tending to my goats and trying to stay away from people.
Okay, well, that's good when, you know, that's your thing.
I don't like to be touched.
Good to know.
You should show Dylan the t-shirt.
Ooh, Dylan.
These are the t-shirts that are on the market tonight.
Ooh.
This is how you let people know important information about how much fart is loaded.
Okay, but...
Don't you ever wish you could let people know how much you've loaded?
But it's just like a lie, like, most of the time, right?
Well, you take it right off once you go past the point of 85%.
Okay, so once you get there, you're like, hey, look,
I gotta put this shirt on. And then once the actual sound is made, then you can take the shirt right off.
Well, and it's important to take your shirt off before you do that.
Yes.
Yep.
You know a lot about taking shirts off.
I do.
One might say you're an expert. I also have this wonderful shirt as an option for the winner.
Now that's a shirt. That's a shirt. That's a shirt everyone can get behind. You know what Bay stands for?
I wasn't sure. I couldn't figure it out. I thought maybe it was a tornado warning.
No, it's before anyone else. Walruses and tigers catch herpes.
How come there's no periods? If it's an acronym.
Well, not all. I mean, FBI, they don't always put the dots in.
The FBI doesn't always put the dots in. I've eluded them many a time. They'll never fill in my dots. That's what I always tell the FBI.
You don't fill much dots, do you? I feel like we're always going to get this glare on our glasses. It's driving me crazy.
That glasses glare is just a part of life.
But nobody can see my eyeballs. Like, for you, it's good.
You could take your glasses off because you don't need them.
Well, then I can't see anything.
Maybe you don't need to. Maybe being blind is ideal.
Well, glasses on, glasses off. I guess I don't really care, but it feels like it would be distracting.
No, it's good. It's just like a Star Trek movie.
Yeah, but you look even cooler. Look at that. You got like five things going on. But me, it's just like I look like I'm totally... Look at this. I'm totally...
You should tilt your head down.
Robot Dylan.
Tilt your head down in a humble...
I am Robot Dylan.
If you look down like a humble person, then people won't see those reflections.
I do not understand your command.
Don't be so proud all the time.
I ain't too proud to beg the temptations. See, but then I look like an idiot. It's this robot. I guess I always could be looking up like this. All right.
That's
so
good.
On what people want, I guess.
I have a question for you, though, Dylan.
Sure. Maybe I just look at you.
Are you a holla back girl?
No, I'm a boy.
So you ain't one?
Not, I guess I ain't one. Why do you ask?
I just wanted to check. I always like to check and see if people are hollabacks.
I ain't no hollerback girl.
I got a thing here from Matt Carlson. He says, Courtney is already giggling from the corner. I'd better make sure they get even more boozed. Three shots, one for her, one for Hal, and of course, an entrance shot for Dylan.
Oh, I like this guy, how this guy thinks.
Who will be entering Dylan? Here's a shot glass I prepared just for you.
Oh, thank you. Did you make it out of a wood?
I did. I carved it myself and put... Or I might have gotten it from Courtney, I forget.
You definitely, yeah.
Sometimes I carve things and then other times I get them from Courtney as a gift.
Oh, this has, Don't tell me. Don't tell me. It's one of those... See, this is very embarrassing. I feel ashamed even knowing you and...
It starts with a D.
Yeah, I knew it does. I knew it does. I know it does.
I gave him the D.
He gave me the D. This is a lot. It's a Dagobah system. No, it's a... drone. It's something little... It's a Databot. It's a Dahlia. It's close to Dahlia.
It's close to Dahlia.
Don't tell me it. Give me another little. It's a dag wood.
You'll be exterminated if you don't get this.
Oh, it's a dill. It's a I'm so close. I'm such an idiot.
The correct answer was Dalek.
Oh, I was close. And you told me. Oh, that was. Oh, wow.
I need Courtney's shot glass for this potion.
I'm an idiot. I don't know what things are.
Can you sing the idiot song while I pour these shots?
I'm an idiot, that's for sure, oh, and I don't know what a Dalek is no more. Is it too much weed, or just don't care? I don't know. I'm an idiot, and Hal's the best. It kind of got away from me at the end.
Are you sure you want it poured in what's remaining of this?
Sure.
Chug that down now.
Dalek, they could have done better. Daleks, that's a bit, I don't like that. No, it's forgettable. Like, that thing should be called, like, a scatterzor, or...
I think it should be called a sprobot.
Sprobot?
Yep.
Well, I don't think it needs the word bot in it. I like that it avoids that, but...
Maybe just a sprotac?
See? Fucking sprotacs?
I would be more scared of a sprotac than a Dalek.
Yeah. A Dalek? That just sounds like someone just, like, you forgot its last name.
If you,
oh, it's Tom Dalek.
If you pronounce it in England, it's Dalek.
Dalek?
Dalek. It kind of sounds better. Because if you're an American, you say Dalek.
Especially where we're from.
Dalek. It's a Dalek. It's a Dalek.
Yeah. So maybe it's just our fault. It's a Dalek. A Dalek.
It's a Dalek.
Nah, it doesn't sound any better.
Sounds like a dollar. Sounds like money.
A Dalek.
Money. I put $5 on money.
Honey's play me close like butter on toast.
Is that a rapid, a rapper?
That's a rapid.
A rapid?
It is.
Like a short rap?
It's a snippet of a rap.
We can do raps here.
No, we can't.
Get up.
Get funky.
Then get down.
Oh,
that's a rapid.
It's a rabbit. More rabbits. Matt has said all the good ones, unfortunately.
Dylan, how are you not an expert? Psychological sprotac sounds sexy. I like a crappy. Shorty's Gaming really likes fish.
Like the band?
No, not the band. Crappies, like the...
Oh.
The swimming ones.
Yeah, okay.
I live in Dalek, Texas. We're all exterminated, says Plasto Joe.
Oh, I... Dalek.
They have open carry lasers in Texas. If you're a Sprotac, you can carry lasers around freely.
There's a lot of cats in the town.
How do I convince my wife that she is, in fact, a cleverly crafted cheese ball? What you need to do is make her sit over an open flame, and then when she starts to melt neatly and evenly over your dinner, she'll understand that she's a cheese ball. Unless she starts screaming, in which case she might not be a cheese ball. In my experience, cheese balls don't scream unless you got a special deal at Empire Market on a screaming cheese ball.
You might be a cheese ball if your uncle smells like Limburger cheese.
That's a Texas joke.
Damn shooting, Alabama.
A rabbit is a hip-hop rabbit. That's another meaning of that word, but not the one we're talking about.
You got it totally wrong.
A lot of words have multiple meanings.
Yeah.
And a rabbit is a rabbit rapping, but also our definition.
Yeah. And a bunny, obviously, is associated with hip-hop, not rap.
Rick Grimes says, which song and dance will summon the best demons on AutumnHal Equinox? I think Dylan knows the answer to this. Which dance is best for summoning demons? I know you do this on a regular basis.
Yeah, I do. You know, it's a weird answer. Neil Diamond's Cracklin' Rosie.
Cracklin' Rosie?
Yeah.
Can you sing a little snatch?
Cracklin' Rosie down on the pie. Dun 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 on the bottom bed. Oh, take it slow. You know how it goes.
Oh, wait, stop, stop. No, no, something. No, you're summoning. No, I don't want that one summoned. I don't like that one. Please.
Rosie, I will. No, no, no. Child,
oh, no, no, no.
You
no.
got the way no, no. to make me happy.
Who is that? Rosie, I will. Shalawa sing chapi for sakala mika na wa sama wish. I dispelled that demon. That so demon, good. I don't like it when
on
it comes
on and on.
That demon.
Running out. Up.
Don't summon him back again. Every right. time he comes, he wrecks my toilet.
So anyway, everyone should be singing that Neil Diamond song everywhere in public. Not stupid Sweet Caroline, that harlot.
S. Ninja Lolo says, E. How many real $20 does it take to win at beer and board games?
I think you're an expert at that as well.
Yeah, two Tubmans.
Two Tubmans?
Two of them. These guys, they need $40, so... As that pretty much wins them over.
Has Tubman replaced whatever...
In my mind, she's already has.
Who is she replacing? Andrew Jackson?
Yeah.
Because yeah. He was in a duel or something, right?
No, that was Alexander Hamilton. No, I mean, Andrew Jackson might have been in a duel. No, he was a very populist...
He was a slave owner.
Yeah, a lot of people are slave owners. Yeah, you know, and, he, you know, kind of trail of tears. He's not a good guy, but, man, they're not all good guys. But anyway, he's going on the back where he should be, and a black woman's going on the front, so whatever. But, you know, the Battle of New Orleans. Oh, nah, man, in the winter wood a-coming. Oh, nah, nah, it's a very lyrical-driven song. I'm not sure I can give it justice, but.
I'd like to give you the justice.
That was a good topper there.
I came in at a weird time because all I heard was, when he comes, he wrecks my toilet. Sarah Jane, you've misunderstood.
I don't wreck any toilet.
In a humorous way.
I mean, I did drop that bowling ball on your toilet once. But
that was because we were trying to turn my bathroom into a bowling alley.
It worked.
It did work for a day.
Yeah, but that guy who set up the pins was just not having it.
No, he was union. He was very expensive.
Yeah, but we don't fault them for that.
It was worth it.
I mean, it was a one-man union. It's not much of a union. Come on.
That's true. Don't trust a one-man union. That's what I learned on that day that I tried to turn my bathroom into a bowling alley.
Yeah, that just means you're a poor negotiator, I think. We're all in a union of one.
I don't negotiate. I make deals. I don't. Wait, no, I don't make. I get what I want. Without sacrificing anything. That's not true, I don't.
Baby, you're just what I needed.
Matt Carlson says, can this go out to Dr. Moley? He rocks and he saved me thousands on prescription prices. So he totally deserves this. Also, let Brett know how he'll die in Chicago. Because he will, most likely.
Let's give it up for Dr. Moley. He's just a delight to be around, right?
Dr. Moley is a real sweetheart.
Like, he's got good intentions. That's what I like about him. And he's so, I don't know, I love hearing about him. And
I'm awful sorry that Dr. Moley is being tased every Tuesday and Thursday.
But he's got a pretty good attitude about it, right?
And those cops are taking his pills.
Yeah, but he's clearly, like the people on Facebook are saying, he's got to follow the orders of the police.
That's true. He probably just visits.
Yeah.
Mad Bamberson every Tuesday and Thursday to make it.
Like, I saw Dr. Moley posted something, and he's getting those, hey, you need, what are you doing? You gotta do what the police tell you, then they won't tase you. So I put an article about how Irish people used to be slaves, just to kind of spice it up a little bit, right?
And what was your point? That they also got tased?
Yeah, and white people used to be slaves. No, it's we're getting it. I apologize. Let's all forget this. I'm making complicated satirical
It sounds pretty dramatic, but this is what happens around the equinox. There's a lot of upheaval and change.
Yeah.
As the seasons go from summer to autumn.
I'm just saying, don't justify slavery ever. There you go.
That's something we can all agree on. Anyway, back to what Matt Carlson was saying before this horrible rant. He said that Dr. Moley
started it, that Dr. Moley.
Dylan maybe needs an extra M on his can before he's totally trustworthy at this point.
Yeah, no. I learned something from Dr. Moley tonight. Make a subtle point. That's always a smart strategy.
Also, this...
We have a lot of questions, too.
Also, this man, Bwet.
Bwet?
We gotta predict how he's gonna die in Chicago. Of course he will, because...
You're the one who does that.
The one thing I will say, this isn't political. Most people that go to Chicago get killed. That's just the facts.
I think you're gonna be okay, sources.
But... I have sources.
Yeah.
My sources are every news article that I read. They always end the article with, oh, by the way, a lot of people get killed in Chicago. Here's how Bwet will die.
It's all relative.
I go into a trance, I'll be gone for a second.
Okay. What should I do?
Just try to channel the spirits.
Get in there.
Bwet will die when he is gunned down in cold blood by a large... sort of rabbit. The rabbit can speak. It's a white rabbit with a stopwatch. It will say it's in a hurry. Bwet will follow the rabbit. Then when they get to a hole, the rabbit will jump in and Bwet will follow the rabbit. And then Bwet will fall down the hole deep and see all kinds of furniture. And then the rabbit will shoot him in the head. What happened? Did I predict it?
I don't know what happened. I got sucked in, too.
I got more things here from people. Go ahead, though, Dylan. We got a lot of questions.
Go ahead. What?
Courtney giggle counter 5. It just went to 6, Morning Bunyan, because I heard her giggle at what Dylan said. She laughs a lot at Dylan because he's silly. That's number 7.
Oh, that's... We need, like, one of those conductor counters if we're going to be... Okay. That didn't get an 8.
What is everyone's potions they are drinking tonight?
Double M Hams. And whatever you got me, I didn't drive here because my wife said I can't do that anymore.
And then we finished off this...
That's very smart.
Yeah.
Wisdom potion. This is wisdom potion right here, Sage.
Ooh. So, what's... I need some wisdom, clearly. Let's get this. Is there some business?
Dylan sounded like he was trying to drop a load.
2 birds, 1 stone.
Is that the new album from Cake? Dylan knows about business.
Once stone.
Dylan runs his own business. It's called Dylan Brogan Corpse. The Dylan Brogan Corpse?
It's a business I started where I have sold my soon, or not soon, but eventually deceased corpse. I sell shares of it, of how much my corpse will be worth. It's traded like a bond.
He's going to share his corpse?
So right now my corpse is worth $250, but you can bet if it's gonna go higher or lower. I've got quite a, you know, like the New York Stock Exchange? It's like that, but...
The New York Corpse Exchange?
I'm not on that. One day I hope to get on the Corpse Exchange.
I'd like to invest in your dead body.
Okay. Well, you need to contact your broker.
Okay, I can do that. His name is Samuel F. Jackson.
Why was that funny? All right, it was, though. Samuel F. Funny.
No, his name is Samuel F. Jackson. There's nothing funny.
Oh, you really
about
should
it.
Get Samuel F. Funny because he's a way better.
I never heard of
him. All right. Well, you just have him call my people and they'll get you all. You know, I really should be telling you this is insider trading, but I'm feeling good. So I'd bet this is a good time. It's low.
Mostly what I like to invest is I have a lot of onions and chowder.
Oh, well, I heard chowder was doing great this year.
So I can use that for investment currency on your corpse exchange?
Like I was saying, you know, the kind folks at Edward Jones will probably help you figure that out.
Edward Jones?
Financial.
They sound like they're from the Old West. I got a thing here from Eric Ross. He says, you're doing a great job, Nuggets. Please predict America's doom. I feel like Dylan would be pretty good at this, but... In order to do it, he's going to have to put his hand on the future.
Okay. Ooh, like, doom. What's America's doom? Okay.
America's doom.
All right, so how do you do this?
When you put your hand on there, you'll feel the currents of the future when you touch it.
Okay. Stop! But always been doomed.
But you are supposed to predict how.
This is, we're already there. It's been doomed.
There might still be some.
No. When, okay, predicts America's doom, it already happened, buddy. This is it.
There might be some residual.
Oh, get out of here. You can't reject my, no. The spirits say no. I'm sorry. You leave the crystal ball, we trust it. Somebody asked how America's doom was. It's already been doomed, buddy.
I saw the movie Idiocracy. I think that pretty much sums it up.
I think mine, ironically, saying America was doomed long ago.
Do you have a specific?
Inception.
Like a specific way in which it dies?
It's like saying...
Just one word.
How does that dead guy die?
Can you give me one word?
Democracy.
There you go. That's your answer.
Oh, that's really sad.
Dylan just predicted America's doom by democracy.
Sorry, folks. Benevolent King 2020.
What he meant to say was reverse totalitarianism. You should look it up. I got something here from Andrew Grindstaff. Can he let us know what he'd like?
What he'd like?
What, me, Hal? I should let you know what I'd like. Andrew, I'd like, I need a new...
Two turntables.
I need two turntables. I need a microphone. I need 5 sacks of flour for my annual autumnal pancake breakfast.
We need it now because we got to get started.
It is. We're already a day late and it's happening tomorrow morning. So if you could get those overnight expressed, I need that flour quick. And then I also need some butter.
Can I clarify? PayPal is being jerky again, and it didn't include the text for Andrew, so I asked him what he'd like, but I haven't heard.
Oh.
So I was hoping he'd hear that. Can you also let people know that I usually respond and thank them, but Gmail and PayPal aren't connecting? So they'll get thank yous, they'll just be late.
You're going to get thank yous, but they'll be late.
PayPal is paving over parking lots. Paving over
in Pasadena.
Are they putting up parking lots, and they paved all over?
And Gmail's got gonorrhea in Guam, so there's issues. They're working it out.
So let us know what you'd like via the email, and we'll give it to you, Andrew.
Give it to me. Give me that. How do you prevent eagles from tossing the goats off cliffs? That's a good thing.
What you need to do first is kill Don Henley. That's the quickest and easiest way. Then he will no longer be able to throw goats off cliffs. I'm going to read a couple more questions before I get to the cards. All right, I got to go cry because I'll never know Dylan's favorite Hamilton line. It says oven butt. That's a pretty good username.
Why will you never know?
It's like your butt is an oven. What?
Why would he never know?
What's your favorite Hamilton line? He's afraid he'll never find out. Can you give us the inside information?
My favorite Hamilton line? Just you wait. Just you wait. There you go.
Did you listen to Hamilton?
It's from the musical.
Did you go see it?
No, but I've heard the soundtrack.
Courtney Giggle Counter has gone up one.
Boop!
Gassy Norseman says Hotmail once manipulated my prostate.
They still do that. Yeah. That's where I go for my prostate.
Whenever I send them an email, they always manipulate my prostate into their spam folder. You should use angelfire.com. That's the best place for email nowadays. That or Lycos. Both very good.
I'm sticking with Netscape.
Netscape is good. Don't use AOL, though.
No. It sucks.
I got a message from Christine Luschow. You're all amazing and have brought much-needed joy to the end of a long week. Please rock, paper, scissors for the shot between you three.
All right. Aww.
Can you get your hand over here?
How do I do it again? I forget.
How to play rock, paper, scissors?
Can we see your hand?
You gotta scoot a little closer, or we gotta go a little closer.
There it is. That's Courtney's hand.
No.
All right, okay, ready? Rock, paper, scissors. We go one. We go and then thing.
Mm-hmm.
Ready?
Thing.
Yeah.
Thing. Oh.
Oh, I got all cut right. up.
Ready?
Now it's just you two.
Okay.
Thing. Oh, she's
looks
smart.
Like Courtney wins.
Oh, thank you.
Give us your shot glasses.
I hope she's okay because I think she's in Iowa.
Ooh, there's we're really flooding. Sorry.
No, because of the flooding.
Oh, doubly sorry.
Iowa's very pretty this time of year.
I think Iowa's except great. I love Dubuque.
I heard there's a lot of flooding in Iowa. It was all the pigs have diarrhea. Creates a lot of flooding.
Oh, this is massive.
Whoa. That's probably two shots I accidentally poured you two. Wow. One in advance of whatever else happens. Thank you, Christine.
Yes, thank you, Christine.
Thank you, Christine.
Once I went to Iowa and I went to the college and I interviewed some people. They made me take off my glasses, but it was me.
And they made you take off your glasses because you were too... rapey was the word.
Did they say that?
Who is they?
The people that were doing the...
Poncheros. What are you talking about?
I'm not sure I'm supposed to talk about it, but I'm going to talk
did
about it.
Did that go well?
It was 3 years ago.
I did an advertisement for Poncheros. They hired me to go speak with some students.
But we don't like the glasses.
And they said I couldn't wear these glasses because they was too rapey. I'm not sure what that means. It made me feel kind of funny. Anyway, I took the glasses off and I went around and talked to some students. And then I got touched inappropriately.
See, they didn't want...
The college students have no boundaries.
Imagine how bad it would have been if you would have had the glasses on.
They come right up and they touch... So it was the opposite. If I had my glasses on, maybe I would have been protected, but instead I was molested during the shoot. Anyway, thanks, Poncheros.
The best weekend he's ever had.
Also, Andrew would like you to predict his doom. Ha ha ha.
I can do that.
I hope you're not dead. Then it's going to be boring.
Andrew Grandstaff, I'm going to predict your doom. He's not dead yet. He'll be dead eventually, though.
All right, I just want to hang out. I don't want to summon any spirits with you.
You predicted the death of America very concisely.
Okay, fine.
Andrew, this is what will happen. I see a glowing sphere. It looks like the sun. The sun is getting bigger. It's going to explode. It's growing gigantic and consuming the earth. It's burning up everyone's pants.
Not our pants.
And their socks and galoshes. Everything is getting burned.
Sounds like all of our death.
I think, Andrew, that means that you're going to live until the end of time itself.
Oh, good for you. Good for you.
That's good news for you. It might be the pine needle method of cryogenically preserving yourself.
And the cats and the cradle and the silver spoon.
And the pine needle stuck into your womb.
Don't know, Daddy, I don't know when.
We'll be together then.
Boy.
We know the sun will explode then.
Boy.
You know. Gonna end the galaxy then.
And the cats in the cradle. All right.
And the whole earth is dead and the silver moon. Everything is destroyed, including the poon.
The poon!
And all the baboons.
No, stick with poon.
Sorry, stick with poon.
And I really meant
that's
to stick
Dylan's
with
slogan,
poon.
Stick with poon.
Dad.
No, I'm
stick
going
with poon,
to stick
Dad.
With poon,
the Dylan Brogan
Dad.
Story.
Now I'm going to stick with poon. That's good advice.
I really should have. All right, yeah, that's good advice.
You can trust us. He's got hams and I have ham. Do we have some questions?
Hal, are you concerned about global warming?
Sarah Jane Eldrick fears and worships me. That's the appropriate response. I do have expertise, but You also must understand that you can learn a lot from me, but I'm also, my knowledge can be dangerous. Some people consider that I have too much knowledge and maybe know a little too much. If I reveal too many things to you, it could drive you to madness.
He's considered a hate crime in many states.
I am. Caterpillar in the Cradle and Silver Spoons with Ricky. I don't see any questions. I'm going to go to this next thing from Matt Carlson. He's going nuts tonight. Matt Carlson is in Chicago.
Woo! Chicago!
I heard that he met up with AaronYanda.com.
Is that where Aaron?
And they hung out and shot a video for Game Society Pimps.
Oh. I thought you guys were shut down.
We'll never be shut down. No one can shut us down. We don't need to be friendly to advertisers.
Fuck them.
Fuck them. I mean, wait, I don't swear. Well, you made me swear. Now we're not advertiser friendly. This video is now flagged.
White power.
Is that a type of, is that what runs the light bulbs?
Yes.
Matt Carlson says, on that awkward note, Matt Carlson says, I can't actually watch tonight, so I'm just going to assume Dylan needs two more drinks.
Yeah, pretty much. I just yelled white power.
He did. He needs help. If by chance he's already nude and passed out, give them to Hal and Courtney.
Oh, no.
You're going to get two more drinks right away?
I'm going to get two more drinks right away. I'm going to get two drinks. Right,
I'm
going
to fill this all the way up to the top. I think this is about four.
Tippy top.
About four.
No, let's do half. Four no, shots. Ali. This is old granddaddy.
Just a little bit
no,
more.
No, not.
There we go. That's about, that's only one shot.
This is a.
It's really like this many. Chug it all down.
That's what my old granddaddy always said.
Mm. He was smart. Good thing you had a chaser, a ham chaser.
That is deceptive. I thought I got it all down, and it wasn't even close.
But it kept coming.
Oh, do you see how that was not good?
That's what he
said. Any other human being would have vomited there, but I just took it.
He thought he had it all down, but it kept coming. Thank you, Matt Carlson. I'm sorry you can't watch this. I hope you can watch it after you escape Chicago. If you make it out alive, maybe you'll be able to watch this full broadcast.
Oh, you'll be fine.
They don't have internet in downtown Chicago. I've been there. They don't even know what it is.
No.
It's like going into a cave in the Dark Ages. Where do we post to get our comments on air?
Right there.
I'm loving how musical Dylan is being. Dylan, he's actually been in musicals.
Yeah.
He was in
Kenya.
Kenya. The musical. All about Kenya.
It's in Africa.
It is in Africa. It's called Kenya. And it's in Africa. That was a classic. And everyone's dressed like cats. Drunk Portuguese Dylans are the meaning of life.
Portuguese, oh, I'm a Portuguese, life is, but not.
Oh yeah, get the little guy all drunk and out will come the boobies, says Hayes Motes.
Courtney?
What's that?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
I think that was harassment. You better get him some more shots.
Let's just say I'm an A cup. Or not even that, I'm a Zelda cup.
Zelda?
I'm a Zelda?
Are you H-O-Z?
I'm the opposite. Yeah, get that. Why does that plum get so, or that, what is that?
It's a giant plum. Someone said maybe the focus is bad on the camera, so I'm trying to get it to focus on us.
Well, why? You look at it, you got a prominent
couch. I got a lot of
couch.
Stuff. Yeah, I got a lot of stuff in the way. Maybe if I move it back, it won't focus on the stuff.
That's how he kind of likes it, though.
Life is always out of focus for some of us who can't see right.
It's me.
I got laser ocular surgery on my eyes, so I wouldn't have to wear my glasses. Hal, are we cool? You haven't been answering my crystal sphere calls, says the cryptid hunter. If you want to call me right now, I suppose I could take that call from my crystal sphere. Hello, is this cryptid?
Will you accept a call, a caller?
A collect call on my crystal? That'll cost so much of my soul.
We pay in hams, or we will accept hams?
You'll accept hams?
We also pay in hams?
That seems trustworthy. Okay, patch him through. Cryptid?
Well, yes.
Hi, this is Hal Thompson. You said you haven't talked on the crystal sphere for a while.
Oh my gosh, I've been trying. I thought I had the wrong number.
No, this is the right sphere you called.
Well, thank you for accepting. I never expected this.
Okay, I gotta go.
No!
I got a thing from Brad Wagner. Can you predict what doom awaits poor Beefer and Lolo? I can only hope we both go out as one since we were together forever.
I'm not sure you know that yet.
I know that you were together forever and blarved and slam blarved.
Nope.
Imagine
together
me and
forever
you.
Forever with me.
And you and me. And every night we toss the dice. And
pay the price.
Meet some mice.
Pay the
You're
meat.
The only one for me. And me for you. So happy until Hal says so. Do it.
I hope Beefer and Lolo, I hope you have your ham ready so you can meet your maker.
Is that an affirmative?
Did you get it?
I don't know. There's something about ham that Hal said for all my life.
I'm not sure that should continue.
Don't make me laugh, Hal.
Now I have to find out how Lolo and Beefer die. This is terrifying for me.
I was setting you all up there.
I don't really want to know. What? Lolo and Beefer, you will be together in a park when you are accosted by a man named Wayne. He will ask you for directions. Then he will give you a hug. He will hug both of you at the same time, and you will feel normal for 3 days, and then you will die from too much Wayne affection.
How can I love anybody other than you, even with Wayne syndrome?
Well, I hope you're pleased with learning how you're going to pass, Lolo and Beefer. Maybe you can avoid men named Wayne in your future. That's my guess. He might lie, though, and say his name's not Wayne. He might say his name is Blaine or Slane.
Sloan.
Someone said I was going to kill Slane. I mean, Sloan.
You are?
Someone said I might.
You couldn't kill him. If you would have already.
I would have already killed him if I should have.
He would already be dead if Hal wanted to kill him.
I let him live.
I mean, basically, you just have to put a candy bar out on the sidewalk.
And then the Slane came.
And then you Slane cane him to death.
Slane cane.
Slane cane! All right, what else we got? Thanks, Hal. You're welcome.
Dylan, you're such a...
about Dylan and Cookie.
Robin Christ says, Dylan, you're such a Dylan face.
Well, you know, I wish, and I can't even propose the idea, but Baby Cookie needs to have some sort of relative, right?
She has a mother and father.
But she could have another figure,
once
like,
at a party.
Like a cousin, where...
Don't you remember they appeared once at a party at your house?
And you ignored them?
All right. No. All right, get out of here. There were a lot of people, I was very high, and believe me, I noticed you. And you guys have, and I was deeply touched and honored that you came, but you guys are hard guests to please because it's hard to hang out with someone who you're afraid of standing next to.
I wasn't there, but I understand.
All right. We need to make amends for that, by the way.
Any, that was, what?
I think about that.
Where is the beloved baby Cookie? Perhaps you've seen on her Facebook page, she recently obtained a new place to live in a small trailer home.
In a trailer court?
In a trailer court.
She's, I love the trailer court because it makes me feel special.
She's out of the gutter and into the nutter.
I'm a baby cookiness impersonator.
You sound like you might be
Baby Cookie's cousin?
A she-male?
Are we still talking about Baby Cookie?
You sound like a Sesame Street character.
Are we still talking about Baby Cookie?
You sound like Elmo.
Are we still talking about Baby Cookie?
No.
I tried. I tried and failed, folks, to introduce a Delilah Cookie into the world.
Stephen McDonald says, hashtag needs more Dylan nips.
Don't worry, we're getting there.
Graham Pye says, E-Hal, reveal the secrets of the squash. It's no longer watching you. The squash always takes focus. That's what you learn if you do a scene with a squash. The squash always steals focus. It's not a good improviser. Never have a squash on your show.
They tend to fail.
See what happens when we put the squash up? What are you paying attention to now? Let me guess. The squash. Do you see how the squash ruins everything? Touch that squash.
I don't like how bulbous it's bulb. I don't like it.
It's just a squash.
No, it does kind of look like a, right? Like,
hey, I'm a Canadian goose!
There you go. I'm done.
It does look like a Canadian goose. That was a good point. But the squash stole your focus.
All right, let's get that away from
me. I'm just
going to
put it right here.
Little
if you could not touch it, I'd rather you didn't rub your hand up and down.
No,
it.
I'm just, it feels good on my hand. Oh, my God. I feel like I need, get that thing out of here. This is a family show. Get it out of here.
The squash
push
is
it in. Push it in.
Stealing my
I'm
focus.
I'm pushing it in. I'm
the
pushing
squash
it
is
in.
Really stealing my focus.
Oh. Aaron, I feel like we just went through something. Can we go out to brunch tomorrow?
There's a bunch of stuff down here now. Are we going to do the walk of shame together?
No, we're not.
You know when you walk home from the grocery store with a squash? I'm Hal Thompson, and I'm an expert. Send me your final questions. Any final donations would be much appreciated.
Final? This can't be over.
For shots.
We gotta give away these.
We gotta give
out
away
the
these
before
shirts.
Anyone else stuff.
We gotta give away these shirts. And this is your last chance to get in for them.
I feel like you should have to pay to not get this t-shirt.
We haven't gotten too many things tonight, so you might have a good opportunity to let folks know the information about your farts.
Yeah, this one, we'll mail to someone you hate, too.
Or perhaps to let your bae know that you're on a watch for them.
No, that's a fucking t-shirt.
That's a fucking I swore again because Dylan.
Look at this. I am terrible. Here, I got a doobie. You want to smoke it?
Got a postcard. Can you sign this postcard, Dylan? Then they
yeah, I even brought
might
a
like
pen.
To enjoy it.
I even brought a special
Look,
pen.
If you put it at the right spot, it looks like. Oh, this is going to be so clever.
Oh, God.
Look at this. Look at, I'm Hal Thompson,
God.
And
it's
I'm
weird.
And I'm a sleepy eye closed expert. This is how I'll be doing the rest of the show.
God.
That's pretty cool.
It's really.
I'm really happy I discovered that. Get those donations in, and we'll get this prize drawn. And if you want shots for us, let's do it. Dylan the Squash Toucher Brogan, that's your new nickname. We'll call you Squash Toucher.
I am a squask toucher. All right.
I'm the rhyme mangler.
That is really my name. Oh, you guys bring out the worst and best in me. But everyone out there, you just gotta give it up for Hal Thompson. When you need him, he's there. When you're feeling low, or it happens to be the day when the amount of sunlight and nightlife are exactly the same, he's there.
That's right. When there's equal amounts of sunlight and nightlife, I will be there.
I'll be there.
Said he, if you'd like to make a donation, go to the description of this video. For every $20
Who doesn't want that Bay shirt?
That you
Baywatch.
That you send our way, you get entered.
And for every $50 donation, we definitely won't send you that fart shirt.
If we get enough last minute donations, I'll give away both shirts tonight. I'm crazy like that sometimes.
Or you can pay to not get that fart shirt.
Yeah, that's true. If you don't want
Because we might just we're good with whitepages.com. We can look your shit up and send you this t-shirt. What will you do then?
Yeah, we
should
can...
I drop it off at Goodwill or should I make it into a rug? Nothing.
You should make it into a rug, definitely.
That takes time.
A t-shirt Baywatch mug.
No, that's rug. The good one. We're talking about the fart one that I'm offended by.
Because you always have a fart 85% loaded?
No, because I always have a fart 84% loaded.
Because you're always 85% loaded. Am I right?
Well, ding, when I hang ding, around ding, you...
Ding. Ding dong.
Bong ding, bong. Ding dong dong.
Dong 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 dong.
Why, after I stroke that, why are you calling it dong? No, we did that. That's over. No, okay, all right. Whew, God, get this
I got kind of hungry for squash.
No, dude. I just prevented you from crossing a line here.
Which line, the county?
No, you suck on your own squash and this whole thing is over. I just saved you.
I never suck on my own squash.
Exactly. So why were you about to do it?
I forgot myself for a second. Squash stole
focus. You're welcome.
Squash stole focus.
You're damn right it did.
Squash stole focus. Squash stole focus.
Unique New York. Unique New York.
Squash stole focus. Squash stole focus.
Squash stole focus. Squash stole focus. Squash stole focus. Unique New York. You know you need unique New York.
S Ninja Lolo is gonna like and tell everyone that she's a YOLO lifeguard.
You only live once, lifeguard?
So she lets people, like, perish in the water?
You only live once, so...
She shouts at them, you only live once, and then she lets them dip below the water level.
No, I feel like that makes her a better lifeguard, because if you only lived once, she'd be like, fuck, that bitch doesn't only lives once, you better save him, not like, you only live once, enjoy the experience of drowning slowly, that's not a thing.
Drowning is underrated.
Definitely. It's supposedly heavenly.
Oven Butt, if you want to enter the giveaway,
go Oven to Butt?
paypal.com/ovenbutt. Decide whether you'd like to predict your doom or if you'd like us to take a shot. Send us $20.
All right, how about
email
we do this?
Email address is in the description.
I'm tired of giving it away for free. We got to get at least somehow $100 of drink money before I take my shirt off. And you know what? If it doesn't end with my nipples, everyone is going straight to hell. I'll see you there.
Most of you men know how this works.
Yeah, Dylan, but you women, we need you to pick it up. Most of you men know how this works, but women, you may be unfamiliar. You gotta pay.
Dylan takes off his shirt if we get $100.
You better be good to me. No, I'm not giving it away for free. Next time I will, but tonight.
He's turning into Tina Turner, everyone.
That's how it's gonna be now.
You better be good to him.
Who? Better be good to me. Whisper.
Rebecca Jordan says, hi, Hal. Can I get some special advice? Thanks. Of course you can, Rebecca Jordan.
How do we do that, though?
We're gonna give her special advice.
Okay.
Do you have special advice for Rebecca Jordan?
Just in general?
In general. Think about what you know about Rebecca Jordan. She might be Minnesotan.
Okay, well,
she might be Minnesotan.
She could be Minnesotan.
Oh, if you live in White Bear Lake, move.
She could be in two places.
She might be in two places.
Georgia or Minnesota.
I recommend taking time.
I really
in
hope
each
those are
place.
States and not men.
But really, the advice I'd like to give you is never shine a
dark
corner
in a
lavatory
without
special
hydrogen
protection.
Solid advice.
That's solid advice. We got one more advice for you. Always
put
crayons
next to
a bleacher
for your
godmother.
Don't forget it. She'll love you, and you'll get that inheritance money.
You'll get that, and she'll grant you the wishes as well. That's what godmothers do, right? Or was I thinking of fairy godmothers?
No, I think no, godmothers.
Fairy godmothers.
Yeah, I'm the godmother.
He's the godmother. Grant sheet says predict the death of Brendan Ho. He tends to find himself in inexplicable situations, so I shudder to think how he's going to die. I suspect he'll die in some sort of inexplicable situation. Let's find out what happens to Brendan Ho.
Ho.
Brendan Ho, you will find yourself inside the Museum of History in Washington, D.C. You will be looking at a giant statue of the Egyptian god Osiris.
Whoa.
It will start to shake and shiver, and lightning and electricity will sprout forth from the statue. You will be unable to move. Then the statue will transform into Ryan Seacrest.
No.
Gross.
Ryan with an axe. Ryan Seacrest will say only this. I'm going to kill you with an axe. And then he will chop your head off.
I mean, makes sense.
You're going to be killed by Ryan Seacrest.
We all know he's going to be a murderer.
Egyptian god Osiris.
You know, there's another Netflix TV show.
That's one of the worst ways I've ever heard of to die.
Yeah, there's another, like, Making a Murderer, and it's all about how Ryan Seacrest is basically the new death.
Do they use the song Murder Up?
We've sung that a lot.
I'm a wheel watcher, murder up.
I'm a squeal.
Baker, murder up.
I'm a hot haker.
Murder up.
I'm an oven.
Cleaner.
Murder up. I'm dooming like that.
Ryan's...
Don't go chasing...
Ryan Seacrest walls.
Please stick to your...
Aerosmith songs that you're used to.
Because you know it wasn't always easy to...
Host a reality show.
So you should give them some...
Love.
Yeah.
You're welcome for all those wonderful songs.
False.
We hope
Dylan.
You've brought joy to your world.
Grant Sheet would also like you to predict his doom, too. He says moving to Fargo has to spell doom for me somehow, right?
Yeah.
Grant Sheet's moving to Fargo? Well, let's find out what happens.
Ah!
Grant Sheet, you will die at the age of 96.
But that's when being old's bad.
But not from old age. You will die when your old folks' home is crushed by the foot of a frost giant.
And to think you owned that old folks' home.
I'm sorry I laughed at your doom, Grant. I shouldn't have done that.
Whoop. I mean, it is a forest dwarf.
But the frost giants, they're coming from the North Pole now because it's all melting, and so they're coming south. So beware when you're 96. Oof. Next year, they will come. And they'll come to Fargo first, because that's north. Dylan gets baked enough, he might as well call himself an oven butt.
I'm a confection.
He's like cotton candy. We're getting a lot of things right now. I think we almost have reached the nipple moment.
No, have we?
When do we reach nipples?
I'm kind of busy here because you have a lot of generous people.
All right, we got a lot of generous people.
I think we have made nipple
mode. I think the nips will reveal themselves.
Yeah.
I'd like to do something special with your nipples.
Should Courtney draw something before I make an appearance?
Well, I was going to draw something live.
Okay.
On your chest.
And we can do that.
I know you guys should go ahead with that because some people are still sending.
Okay. Let me get comfortable here.
We're going to go ahead and reveal his nipples as you requested. I got something here from Courtney Schmid. She says, I'm here for the bay. Toast her too. Is this just a shout out?
I wanted you to toast her since she was generous enough to do that.
Oh, very good. She says, I'm here for the bay. And she wants
and
to win.
Her name's Courtney.
Her name's Courtney, and she wants to win the Bay Watch shirt, which is all good. And then we're going to toast Courtney. Congratulations, Courtney. Yay. I hope you win that bay. That's pretty delicious. I could use some water if anyone gets near the sink in their travels through my area. Anyhow, what was I talking about? I don't remember. Oh, the nips. Oven Butt says, okay, but seriously, you guys are super important to me, and I'm so happy to be here and donate. I'm going to cry. I'm such a loser. Don't cry, Oven Butt. Yeah. We love you.
Whoa, Baby Cookie's back.
Thank you for the water.
Let's do this, buddy. So, you know, there's the obvious eye area, but what will... All right, I'm closing my eyes. You're gonna get a fresh reaction here.
We're going to do some body art on Dylan's body due to the generousness of everyone who's watching.
All right, it better be something good. I really feel like Courtney should be doing this because I just feel like you're a better artiste.
I thought you meant something else, Dylan.
No, I just feel like if anyone's gonna...
No, you meant we should be reversing positions here.
Oh, no. Okay. I mean a lot of things, but that is not what I meant in any... That would not be okay. No, I just wish you were drawing on me because you draw something, like, nice. This is getting...
I need the other nipple now.
I'm writing out the...
I know. You got too much to do. It's fine. It's just I don't trust this Hal fool.
Canvas is hard to work with.
I know. You're not an expert on, like, you know, smooth, pale canvases.
I'll do it next time. We'll make a...
Oh, what is going on here?
We'll make time for it. We'll, plan ahead.
There's no way we can plan
I've created
thing.
A pastoral setting
All right.
on Dylan's
can
body.
Can I open my eyes?
Yes, turn towards the camera.
What is going on here?
So this is... This is Mr. Nipples, the rabbit.
Oh, hi there.
Can you see him?
Hi, folks.
That's a little rabbit nip.
Bloop, bloop.
With a nip for an eye.
And then you got a little flower child here.
This is a pastoral setting.
All right, come on. Draw some, like, a horizon line or something. Give us some perspective here. Yeah, I want a mountain and a sun.
There's the mountain, and then here's the sun.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Okay.
But
see?
Wait, Mr. Sun is angry.
Well, of course he is. He's on my side.
He's talking about bringing around the end of the universe.
All right, there you go, folks.
Mr. Nipple the rabbit and that flower.
No!
The nip flower. Flower of the nip.
Nip, nip.
We've created art on someone's chest this evening. I hope you remember this. In your dreams.
All right, we gotta shut shit down quick, but I feel like we have a lot to get through.
We might have a lot to get through. I almost need to take my coat down.
Oh, you can't do that!
Never take it off. I just gotta take it down a little bit.
Okay, oh my god.
Things are heating up in here with all the touching of
the... Can I at least put the hoodie on so it's a little bit more... No? Okay, I guess we...
I don't think so. People have requested that you do this.
But it's like the more I do this, the worse it gets.
Okay. The more you do what?
I'm just saying, like...
Be a nipple slut?
Yeah, the nipple slut thing for 5 minutes is cute. You do it for 20 and it gets a little bit sad.
I won't be sad.
All right, let's get... Now I'm ready to roll here.
Beefer says, a round of potions for all. Now, Dylan, make with the nips. And he already has. In fact, we've drawn art.
It's a one-of-a-kind YouTube experience.
Thank you, Beefer. Let's get shots all around the town.
All right, let's be a little...
We're going to be a little...
Realize you gave me, like, two full
that
shots
That was a double
time.
Shot.
Yeah, no.
Someone let's... requested you have a double shot.
Okay,
weren't
that's
you,
fine.
Weren't you aware
But it was more than
that?
A double shot, and I got to get home tonight, and already...
Did you drive?
This has happened. No,
Are you
no.
the Blitzen Trapper?
Good.
I don't know what that is.
Here, can you pour yourself a shot, please?
I didn't get one, did I?
Yeah, you did.
No, that's why I'm giving that to you.
Wait, why?
For
a shot.
For everyone.
Brad said shots all around.
Oh.
Beefer. Aww. Beefer, I filled my shot way too high now, and I'm going to get screwed.
So later tonight when all the ladies are like, whoa, look at that awesome art you got.
You can tell him it was drawn by Hal Thompson.
Oh, I'm sure the one person who will see that will love it.
You're going to get laid. You might get laid multiple times by rabbits.
Thank you for adding that.
Love nipple art.
All right, let's get away from my sexual
I got a thing here from... I'm just going to watch Courtney drink her shot.
She's drank it. Look at it. She does it like a champ. You don't even have to watch her.
I didn't yet because I'm still writing.
Abigail Generazzo says, give away money, please. She's getting into the drawing for the shirts and for the Hal Thompson postcard. We're going to toast Abigail right now.
Abigail!
Woo. Abigail Glasso, good job getting into the drawing. We're getting a lot of things here at the last minute. This really is the last call, though, for Sirius.
Did you thank Brad? Should I have waited or taken the shot?
Take your shots.
Thank you,
take
Brad.
Your medicines.
Brad. Courtney says thanks.
Matthew Bravo. Carlson, who isn't able to watch this live but can only imagine what's happening.
No, you don't even know.
Because he's in Chicago where they have no internet. He says, predict Dylan's and my death.
No, I don't go in on that voodoo
shit. If we ever actually spent an evening together.
Well, we haven't done that yet. Sorry,
we're both irresponsible extroverts, so it'll probably be gloriously stupid. If you and Matt Carlson ever spend an evening together, you will both die like this. You will enter into a pact with a devil. His name will be Shay Marlson. He will request that both of you complete an impossible mission to fly to Mars with wings of wax. Then he will kill both of you as if he never really said that. He'll knife you. He'll shiv you. Okay.
Wow.
I'm sorry to laugh at that again.
You're not holding it together.
I think when devils do stuff like that, it's pretty funny. Anyway, that's how you guys will die if you ever hang out together.
All right, I didn't even listen.
Good. I'm glad you don't know how you're
and
going
I
to perish.
And I don't stop. Because
believe
me
in
each other.
We're going to get through it together.
We don't know the same catalog.
I'm not singing about a catalog. Chris Olsen says, could you predict my doom, please? I'm going to predict Chris Olsen's doom. Chris Olsen, you will be flying. You will be in a helicopter, a gyrocopter specifically. You will be flying over Mount Rushmore on a tour.
Hey, it's really tall.
You will be looking at the face of George Washington in stone.
Oh my God, George Washington's on Mount Everest.
When all of a sudden, your own son will fire a surface-to-air missile at your gyrocopter.
Hey, Daddy, I'm on the ground.
That's how you're going to perish?
RPG, motherfucker.
It's just the truth. I'm sorry. I have to tell you. Ryan Rogers says, I want Dylan to drink for my enjoyment, and does Dylan remember what my Christmas gift was for him? Even if he still uses it. Do you remember what you got from Ryan that you might use at certain times to cover your body? That's the hint.
Jacket?
Correct.
I like that.
It was a nice jacket.
And I also encourage others to rob leather stores. And send their goodies to me. Because I have immunity. I know Wilson's leather.
Dylan has dip-shit-o-matic immunity.
I do have dip-shit-o-matic immunity. But I also know, Wilson leather. So
he knows Wilson leather personally.
It's sort of like your friend Leatherfoot, Hal. Didn't you have a friend
named a friend named Leatherfoot.
Same dude.
I think Ryan Rogers knows Leatherfoot. We used to hang out.
Leatherfoot!
We used to sight Leatherfoot in the trees.
You used to sight him?
We did. We would sight him. We had binoculars to try to sight Leatherfoot.
Oh, I thought you meant like, here's a parking ticket.
CIT.
No, we didn't give
C-I-T.
Him...
CIT?
We didn't give him parking tickets until he bought that Hummer. And then we had to because he parked it. He parked it in handicapped spots.
But he has AIDS.
Leatherfoot has AIDS.
It's fine now. It's not what it used to be.
It's not what it used to be. Leatherfoot is okay.
He's got a good prognosis. And it's cool to know somebody like that. I do. I remember. Okay. What? You got more business? We got to wrap this shit up.
If we don't have any more business, we must head out for the evening.
We got shit to troll.
We got shit to troll.
Like a pontoon boat that we're going on later tonight with squash.
We're going pontooning with squash later.
You're going to get squash later.
I'm going to get squash later. I'm not sure what that means.
I don't know either.
Leatherface Nipple Man.
He's a Leatherface Nipple Man.
We're close to having double the nips on the stream. That's true. We've had a lot of nips. We've got to shut down the nips.
Right.
We got to close them down.
So I'm going to start.
Courtney's going to prepare the drawing. Any last minute donations?
We don't know how to entertain them.
We can't entertain. We don't know what that means.
Oklahoma weathers.
What?
Here they are now. Entertain them.
Oklahoma, where the sun comes running down the rain.
Oklahoma, where the most of the strain is on your brain.
Whoop, whoop.
Oklahoma, where the schools don't let you believe in science.
Oklahoma, let's give it back
to the Lions.
The St. Louis Lions.
The St. Louis Lions, my favorite football team.
Here, let's tell a history story together. This will be fun.
Yeah, we have a good history story about Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, remember when he protested the...
What?
He
protested the fair, the St. Louis Fair.
In 1901, and it was a big deal. And the reason why he protested...
It's because they were using Edison's electricity instead of Tesla.
And he really was a champion of Tesla. And he also had beef with Edison because...
Because Edison ripped off the idea of electricity from Tesla.
So it's the same beef. Okay, so the and. Okay.
He had the beef that everybody had back then, yeah. But which got glossed over in all the history books.
Is that the King Kunta? Everybody want to make a leg off of Kunta. Black man taking no love. Hoo-ha!
I feel funny.
I got a bone to pick. Where you monkey mouth motherfucker sitting in my throne again?
Is that Big Baby Jesus?
He's bad.
Is that Michael Jackson?
But I ain't stepping. Two friends. One question.
Do you think Michael Jackson and Prince hang out together at breakfast in heaven?
No, but they hang out in a airport lobby occasionally.
A heavenly airport lobby?
No, I wouldn't call it heaven. I mean, he is Michael Jackson.
They get carted around on those big oversized golf carts?
No, you know, Michael Jackson is playing the lounge in hell, and he's fan-fucking-tastic.
Oh, Michael Jackson is in hell? Where's Prince, then?
No, Prince can go to hell, but he's in heaven.
I don't agree with those sentiments.
Why? Michael Jackson's making a killing. Hell is like Vegas. Heaven is like Bronson.
Charles Bronson?
Branson.
Charles Branson?
Yeah, the guy from Death Wish. I love this.
Hal's cheeks are getting rosy.
My cheeks are getting a bit rosy. I think it might have to do with the excess of potion. Might need to go lie down face first in a puddle.
Of...
You should take suggestions for the next stream because folks have had some good ones.
We are looking for suggestions for the follow-up live stream to this one. I don't think we'll be able to do one for Halloween this year, which is unfortunate because my name is in that particular event. We're going to have to skip it.
Why?
Because of all the projects that I have on the roster. I have an a record number of goat projects that I have in prep for October.
And just to clarify for any of the viewers, I never claimed to know any lyrics to songs.
Dylan just clarified some shit for you.
So if you came here to get some Google lyrics, you went to the wrong place.
Morning Bunyan says, why is Thor the god of thunder? He's literally the god of a sound.
Those things are not mutually exclusive.
Those things are not mutually exclusive. You can be the god of thunder of a sound of thunder and also be the god of thunder. That's what we're trying to say.
Well, let's end on a big note.
Dylan, stop fondling your art. He gets that note all the time.
I do. We should do Thanksgiving. I don't have anything going on that day.
Maybe we can do something for Thanksgiving. I think that's a good idea.
Maybe like the Friday after? That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
Can I see that?
No.
Are we almost?
What is it?
Nothing. I'm working.
You guys, let's
leave her alone.
Wait, I have an idea, though. Something you could do while Courtney's filling out all these particular, for the drawing. You guys might want to consider going to CourtneyCollins.com.
Oh, no.
She has a website. She helps out with this show. Seems only right that you go to her website.
You know, I also think
you might like to know that she has a YouTube channel where there's a new video that someone who works on these particular projects we're doing right now may have edited together.
Dylan.
And can I reveal that there might be something secret in that video they should be searching for?
Yes, you should, because no one's found it yet.
No one has found the secret in the Courtney Collins.
I know what it is.
New music video.
I'm not going to say it, but I.
If you look,
I'm just going to say that either way, but I do think I know it.
If you look real close for the secret in her video, you might like to find that, and maybe you'll even get a prize if you do.
I don't think so.
That video's on YouTube. What's the title of that video?
Hot, hot mama rocks.
That's incorrect.
What is it?
It's a preview for Hinterlands.
Hinterlands by Courtney Collins. Go check it out. Find the secret. You won't regret anything. Where does Hal...
You might want 47 seconds of their life back.
Zen of Anger says, where does Hal... Where Hal does a marathon of summoning Shugaths? Normally, I just summon Shuggoths. Yeah. On the occasion that I do summon a Shugoth, it's because I need a new pair of shoes. The problem is, though, those shoes have a lot of eyes in them.
And look for Hal in the new movie, 12 Days to Shuggoth.
12 Days to Summer.
That's a way better.
That's the new movie I'll be in.
I'm sorry, I messed up. That's a way better movie.
That's the movie that I was hired to create by Hershey.
I love Hershey. He makes good movies.
He does. He's a good director. His name's just Hershey.
Hershey!
Did you guys hear that Brangelina broke up? All the Shuggoths are absolutely wrecked by this information because Brangelina was a very powerful Shuggoth.
Yeah, not half as powerful.
Many, many different eyes. And they
four of them.
They served, Brangelina served the old ones to their best ability as long as they could, but eventually they were cleaved in half. Cleaved in twain by the sword of Cruz.
All right, let's do the first giveaway. So you haven't, I have mixed these up for a long time. Look away, look away, look away, look away. You pick one.
This is for the postcard that's signed by all of the folks.
Yep, what is it?
Andrew Grindstaff.
Woo!
He's won.
Don't worry, baby. You're gonna have your Grindstaff real soon.
You won the postcard I was doing the fun visual trick with before, but I
yeah,
can't.
It's right here.
It's right there. If maybe.
By the way, we did this last time, and I did it, and it was really funny. All
did
right.
We do this before?
Yeah, we
That's
did.
That's silly.
Oh my god! But you had the same shirt on. That's incredible. Okay.
No, this is a different one. Can you sign this also, please? CourtneyCollins.com/YouTube.
Preview of Hinterland. All right. What's this one for? The bad T-shirt. This one is the one you didn't want to get, folks. This is the one you paid good money not to get.
Brad Wagner, also
Brad Wagner!
As Beefer. Beefer wins tonight's shirt option, but we're going to, you know what? Because everyone was so generous, we're going to give away both shirts.
Oh, I thought that was always the case.
Beefer, which shirt do you want? The one that explains your fart situation or the one that explains your bae
before
situation?
Before anyone else and watch or whales and tigers catch herpes.
Wait, what now? Brad won that?
Brad won his
choice. Why did you give him the option? No, Brad won the fart one. That's what happened. Sorry, Brad. We
Beefer,
love you.
You're not getting an option.
No, you're not.
Dylan proclaims you the fart winner.
You're the fart winner. Murderer. All
now
right.
This is the
now this is the Baywatch
who
one.
Who wins the Baywatch? Christine Lucio.
Whoa! I'm going to watch that, Bay.
Oh, I need that card. Can you get
yep,
that card?
I'll get that card.
I don't know why I threw that.
All right.
Christine Lucio, you're going to be on a Baywatch in the near future, I suspect.
Good for you, and hey, should I put it on just to get all the juices
oh,
in?
Oh, God, no, don't
yes.
do that, Christine.
She asked about that because she won last time.
Does she want that soil?
Oh, she definitely oh. does.
She wants that sweaty soil.
She wants
soil.
That soil.
They're new with tags, aren't they?
They yeah. are
oh,
new.
Oh, they're new. They're super new.
It was new.
All right,
no,
I'm
going to
do a little workout in it.
Can you at least get in the shot?
Doing moguls.
This is... A sad ending to our apocalypse.
All right,
show.
There you go. That's enough. I sweat a lot.
Equinox show, similar to apocalypse, but not quite. Anyway.
I told Brad that they could pick and they want the bay one.
Christine,
which one do you want?
Yeah, we did kind of override that.
We overrode the bay one already.
But Brad, come on, you're happy.
But Beefer wants the bay watch, so maybe.
Christine, can we work this out amicably?
I'm not sure Christine wants the fart one. Unless you have a friend that you can give it to.
No, that's why Brad's got to have it.
Let
Come
us,
on, Brad.
Let us know, hopefully.
You know you're always 85% ready to take a huge fart. We're not so sure about Christine.
Hopefully we can amicably work something out here.
Yeah, otherwise...
You know what? If nothing else, next time I pass through Wisconsin Dells, I will pick up another one.
That could be decades.
If nothing
no,
else...
No, every other week.
If nothing else, we'll pick up another fart-loading... T-shirt.
Turn it off.
Tell
no.
us what you want. We can't turn it off. We got a few more questions.
Okay.
Dylan, you're not sweaty enough.
Well, that's because I would have to be in a sauna.
That's a good answer, Dylan. Courtney, giggle counter ends at 55 giggles. When a show has reached 55 giggles, it must end.
Boop.
Thank you for joining us, everyone. I hope you had a good time. We really appreciate everyone joining us tonight. We had a really fun time.
I had a better time than I thought I would. And Brad, just take the fart t-shirt.
I will get
We'll take care of
or
it.
Or else you need to wait 1 to 2 weeks to receive another fart shirt.
Like Baby Cookie, I'm here to help.
Baby, she's here to help. Now go touch your squash, and we'll see you next time for maybe for some Thanksgiving, where we'll celebrate the discovery of our country.
Bye, Indians.
And goodbye, Indians.
Shut it off. Shut that shit off.
I'm going to shut this
off. Shut that shit off. Shut that shit. Shut that shit.